Good morning students. In the previous video we have started the chapter the modern period, and in this chapter we have studied about from where we get the information about those periods. So we have discussed books, letter writings, newspaper, administrative reports of the government, internet and databases. So many things we have learned. Now the next point is old buildings, artifacts and people. You can see these old buildings in your book also. There are pictures of these old buildings. So the architectural style of old buildings, artifacts and people of that period also tell us the tales of the past. As we all know these things, I used to remember my great grandfather. He used to tell me stories of his time, that he used to live in Kabul. You know, these kind of things come to us, and maybe these things I am going to tell to my future generations also. So that is the thing, that people also used to tell the stories of the past, and from the buildings also. You can see the buildings. From the buildings also you can understand about our past. Many people who participated in freedom struggle and saw the important changes share their experiences, which throw light on the life of the people and the conditions that existed. So likewise, you are going to tell about this pandemic to your future generation, right? That 2020 was a year of so many hurdles. We used to sit at home. So likewise, these things happen. In the modern period of Indian history, we are going to take a look at India's suffering at the hands of the British imperialism and the subsequent achievement of independence from such power. So in this modern history, in this section of history in class 8, we will study how Indians were being suffered by the Britishers. Britishers policy, imperialism means the policy of expanding its boundaries to use the resources of other territories. So do you know, many changes that took place in the world originated in Europe, like Renaissance reforms, Industrial Revolution, French Revolution, Russian Revolution, Nationalism, Imperialism, etc. And they affected us also. These are the keywords, you can learn them by your own. Now we will take up the exercise. Take the correct option. Modern period of Indian history began in, the answer is 18th century. The call, "You give me blood, I will give you freedom," was given by Subhash Chandra Bose. In which language was the newspaper Kesari published? That was published in Marathi. Which one of the following was a major factor in strengthening the national movement in India? The answer is B, discontentment among the masses against colonial power. The book Unhappy Indian was written by Lala Lajpat Rai. Now fill in the blanks. Land revenue settlements are an important source of information. The answer is information. Collection of Gandhiji's writings has been preserved and displayed at Gandhi Smriti. The Indian National Congress was established in 1885. The revolt of 1857 was ruthlessly suppressed by the colonial power. The Dash Morlemento reforms were introduced in 1909. Now match the following. Amrit Bazar Patrika, it will be Bengali. My Experiments with Truth, Mahatma Gandhi. Simon Commission Report, 1929. Transfer of Power to the British Crown, 1858. Freedom is Our Birthright, that is by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Now these are the questions. All the answers, they are given in the chapter. These are very easy question. What type of information do we get from official records? The answer is from here. You can take out the answer. They tell us about the conditions of the people as well as administration of that time. Simply this line would be the answer of the first question. Number 2. How do letters, writings and speeches provide information? Give example. So the answer of this question is also here. See, they provide us information about the developments that take place during a particular period. एंड इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट एग्जाम्पल यू कैन राइट, अदरवाइज देर इज़ एनी नीड टू राइट द एग्जाम्पल, बट हेयर यू कैन टेल अस लाइक वेरियस, यू कैन पुट अ वर्ड वेरियस, नथिंग यू विल राइट फ्रॉम हेयर, यू विल राइट वेरियस स्लोगन्स, टेल अस अबाउट द पेट्रियोटिक फीलिंग्स एंड नेशनल फर्वर ड्यूरिंग अवर स्ट्रगल फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस. सो दिस इज़ द आंसर फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. Then, question number 3. Mention any 5 major events related to the freedom struggle of India. The answer lies on the first page of the chapter. Here, the answer is C. The major events of the 20th century India were the partition of Bengal, formation of Muslim League, Home Rule League, Jallianwala Bagh massacre, etc. C. From here, to massacre etc. This is the answer of question number 3. Now, next question we will take up, that is, explain any 5 major sources of information about modern Indian history. So this is very easy question because your full chapter is based on the answer. So you can take up any 5, like you will take up newspaper, letter writing, internet or database, according to your own choice. You can take up any 5, and then what is most important, you are supposed to explain them in 2-3 lines each. 5 points you will write, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then first point you will give heading, underline the heading, then explain that in 2-3 lines according to your choice. Then last question, enumerate the steps taken by the East India Company to establish their rule in India. How did the rule of the company come to an end? The answer of this question also lies on the first page. So here D5 I have marked also because it is a little bit long answer. D5, fourth paragraph. The 19th century witnessed various measures adopted by the East India Company to extend and consolidate its control over India, like military action, introduction of railways, postal service, passing different acts, etc. The revolt of 1857 was a major event, but the colonial power suppressed it ruthlessly. So up to here, and then the first part, this is the answer of the first part of the question. Then the second part, how the revolt came to an end, how India got independence. India was able to end the British rule and gain independence in 1947 under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi and many other national leaders. So this is the answer of D5. This we are not going to do. And we have done the exercise of this chapter in the video only, so I am not going to put anything or any work in your assignment slot for chapter number 8. So while you are studying these or doing these question answers, what you should remember, that these question answers questions are the base for other questions that are coming in your examination. You know, questions are going to come from the text only. These questions are also from the text only, but what they do in your question paper, they change the language of these questions. They change the language, and if the children has learnt, you know, ratta mara hai agar inka, then you will not be able to answer the question. If you have gone through the whole text, if you have read, then there will not be any problem in answering any question. So from the very beginning, I am telling you to go through the text carefully, read the chapter completely again and again. You know, social science is not an easy subject. So many students are very bad in social science. The main problem is that they don't learn the text, they just rote memorize the question answers. We are not here to learn the question answers, we are here to understand everything. Understanding is very important. Rote memorization to chote bacche karte hain. Now you are in class 8, you are grown-ups. So thank you students, and in the next video we will start a new chapter. Thank you, have a nice day.